During this activity, an explosion occurred on the 27th of April, 1953, in the forward fire room, which cost 11 lives. Following a two-week period for repairs, the Bennington took part in NATO exercises and made a Mediterranean cruise. During April 1954, the Bennington again began qualification trials, during which a second, much more extensive explosion or series of explosions occurred. This second explosion on the 26th of May 1954 turned out to be a far worse accident and caused over 200 casualties. Extensive repairs were required at the Brooklyn Navy Yard.
My name is Robert John Brock. I was a boiler tender, general, rated man 3, the number 2 fire room in the B division. Served on the Big Bend, sometimes called Bad Luck Benny, due to the loss of men and pilots from the first day on the shakedown cruise in Cuba, which was called Gitmo, and other accidents. Around 6:30 on April 27th, 1953, on the last week of training off Gitmo in number 1 fire room, that's the fire room attached to us, a 5-inch tube downcomer, it's called a downcomer tube, in a superheater. It had 600 pounds of pressure, and then they had one boiler dried to steam out. So you had superheated steam, 850 degrees. That tube pulled out. That killed 11 men. So we sealed ourselves in number 2 right next to them, and we trapped ourselves in there. We were down there for a long time, and we got out of there. Second one, I was in the same place, in the number 2 fire room, same fire room. The number 2 fire room was feeding steam on the same line. Our crew in the number 2 fire room closed the overhead hatches, you know, had the hatches so we could hear, and stayed at our post. The BT-1 broke out fire hoses and used a stream of water as an umbrella to shelter our men. When we abandoned the boiler room sometime later, we escaped to the upper deck, carried not to touch the hot railings and etc. And our crew received letters of commendation for staying at our post. Situation occurred about 6:30. I had been ordered to secure the hatch, the big one, drop it, so we'd slide ourselves in. And which I did, and just as I slammed down the hatch and ready to re-enter the boiler room, I felt the concussion from the hydro catapult boom blow up. They killed 104 guys, 200 some injured. We were 70 miles off the coast of Rhode Island. We were going back to our base. And we had just came back 3 months later. Stalin died so we were at battle quarters because we didn't know what was going on. So when we came back, they're going into the modern carrier where they have a cannon deck. And we used hydraulic oil to drive the catapults. After being down and out, I finally got knocked out. There, in fact, the guy ran into me, he dropped dead. So when I woke up, came out of it, I loaded men on the boiler, what you call a bomb bay elevator. You know, took it up the upper deck, and I put guys on there to sort of go up to the other floor. We were 70 miles off Consett Point, Rhode Island. And 3 days later, they put me on another aircraft carrier and another boiler room, and I ended up in Boston. And that's where I got discharged. I was they had 11 men on the ship watching the boilers, you know, and the fires and the water and all that. So they told me to go back. It was time to get the crew, relieve the crew. The guy forgot to get up. And I had to go from the forward part of the ship all the way back to the third deck to get this guy. Had a hard time waking him up. And he finally went down as he was going into the boiler room. He got hit. He got killed. So, you know, it's, you never know. Your time's up, it's up. I was 18 when I joined the Navy Reserve, active reserve. Way back when I was, by the time I went on active duty, already had 16 weeks of sea duty on all the ships out here. And in Norfolk, and I went to Cuba, was 19 on a destroyer. And that was the night Castro got arrested. And he got 7 years. And then he came out, became the dictator. But, so I was on a cruise of 19 on a destroyer. So I've been on all little Navy ships and other ships. See, when you got discharged, you had to go into standby. And that was the year that Kennedy was going to go to war with Cuba, sent the ships down here. I was lucky they didn't call me. First thing in the Navy is KP, catch a police. He's $16 a day. So what happened is, man, in water, we get a new guy down there, he could do whatever he wanted. And a first class call him over and say, it's time for KP, and it's your turn. I said, what, for me, I didn't do nothing. Yeah, he said, you didn't do nothing, that's why you're going. Post-traumatic stress. You hear a lot about that. And I had that and didn't even know I had it. I was high strung and I was going to turn around the taxi cab and re-enlist. Thought I'd better go home. I went home and I thought the work was like today. You couldn't get any work. And I was the boiler operator. So I was going to join the Air Force. My brother said, you want a blind page? He said, I'll take one. 3 months later, I'm married. We're down a boiler room all the time, you know. I like the Navy, you know. I used to like to go up at being in a boiler room at night. I go out that part of the ship's called the Fantail, and if the waves, and just sit in the evening.